Hi guys, so today I'm in my aunt's house. This is Gouri Mami and she's gonna show us how to bake a cake today.
Hi everyone. Yeah, today I'll show you the way I make the carrot cake. And there are three attractions to this. One, it is eggless. Second, I'm replacing maida with organic multigrain whole wheat atta. So third, of course, it has goodness of carrot. So let's start.
Okay.
First, let's do the dry ingredients and then we'll go to the wet ingredients. Starting with the whole wheat flour. I'll take 1.5 cups. Baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon. And 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Then we'll sift this. So this is our dry ingredients. We'll keep this aside. Then we'll start with preparing wet ingredients. I've taken 1/2 cup of melted butter. And before starting this, I would like to prepare the tray for cake. We'll just use this butter and apply to the side and the bottom of this tray. See that it's even. Yeah. Actually, I can add little flour on this so that we are sure that the cake will not be sticking to this once it's baked. So I'll just spread this. Like this. Let's go ahead with our wet ingredients. 1/2 cup butter and 1/2 cup or little more than 1/2 cup condensed milk. This is sweetened condensed milk. You can take unsweetened condensed milk, but then you have to add more sugar later. Now with this, I'll add only 2 tablespoons of sugar. This condensed milk gives a very good soft texture to the cake because it's eggless. Yeah. Mix it well. Yeah, I think now it's mixed very well. So now is the time when we add the different flavors to it. It depends on your taste and liking. I usually add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract and a little bit, 1 teaspoon of cardamom powder. Some people prefer even adding cinnamon powder, but I usually add only this, just an Indian flavor, cardamom. Just how we use cardamom powder for our gajar halwa. So I use this for cake as well. Yeah. And little bit of vanilla extract. Mix it well. We'll add 2 tablespoons of powdered sugar now. This is powdered sugar. It depends on how much sweet you want in your cake. So we just prefer 2 tablespoons. On the side, I have kept my oven to preheat at 180 degrees Celsius. Now we'll come to the interesting part, that's the carrot one. I have taken 1/2 cup of carrot, grated carrot, fresh one, and I will add a little milk to this. And make a nice paste of this. Basically, I'm doing this just to add more color and more carrot flavor to the cake. Instead of just adding milk, I would add the carrot juice. A nice color. I just need a little more liquid so that it is mixed well with the flour. So I'll add little more milk. Milk should be necessarily room temperature. If it's little warm or little cold, then the cake texture will be ruined. Now it's a nice paste, so we'll add this to our wet ingredients. See, such a nice color. So to this we will slowly add our dry ingredients. Let us take 1/2 first.
So how do you come across this recipe?
Actually, I have watched many videos on YouTube. Everyone had different recipes for carrot cake. I kind of mixed many of those together and added a little bit of mine also. So my friends and all liked this. So I kept on doing the same. The consistency is right, but we are going to add some sliced almonds and the grated fresh carrots. So we need a little more milk in this. In the end, we will add carrot, grated carrot, and the sliced almonds. You can choose any dry fruits that you like. Raisins, walnuts, anything. I usually use almonds. Now I think this is the right consistency. You can see. Yeah. So I'll add, it's about 1 cup of grated carrots. Is ready. See the consistency. We will transfer this into the tray that we had kept ready. See how it falls. This is the right consistency.
What should we do if the batter is too thick or too thin?
Yeah, you can add little more milk. Some people add warm water, but usually I prefer milk.
If it's too thin?
If it's too thin, maybe a little more flour, but then that's like you have to add a little more baking powder accordingly. So I have spread it evenly. point, I'll just add a little bit of this powdered almond, garnishing. It would be better if we had added this in the beginning when the batter was ready and the tray was ready. Take it out after 25 minutes. So it is not yet done. This is the way to check it's done or not. See, you can still see that it is wet here. I'll just keep it back for 7 to 8 minutes. It has raised very well. After it cools down, we'll transfer this to the plate and then we can make decoration or whatever you like. The cake has cooled down after 30 minutes. I'm just taking this on the plate with the almond powder again. Actually, we can use the other side also. If you're putting the cream, then this side is usually even, so we'll have to turn it.
So now the cake is baked and it's ready, and now Anika and Ved will taste it and tell us how it is.
It's good. It's a carrot cake.
So they both liked it, and then
Anika, you also please taste.
Tastes good.
Thank you, Advika, and thank you all.
Thanks for watching.